Hello, my dear students. As per the revised syllabus this year, chapter 1.1 has been omitted. So we move on to the next chapter, 1.2. On to the summit, we reach the top, written by Tenzing Norgay. Now, Tenzing Norgay's original name is Namgyal Wangdi and is often referred to as Sherpa Tenzing. Now, the term Sherpa is usually used for ethnic group of people who are staying in and around the mountainous areas of Nepal and Himalayas. So this chapter gives us an account of his experience of climbing the Mount Everest. He is also there are two people, that is Tenzing himself and Edmund Hillary, who are on to this expedition. Okay, so let's get to the chapter and find out what the author has to share. Okay, the chapter, I'm referring to page 16 of the book. Alright, the chapter begins like this. When we left Camp 9 on Friday morning, I was determined to get onto the top on this day. That morning, I remember thinking I was to get onto the top even if I die. You know, both of them, they were a group of people actually. They are staying in different camps. Okay, at different levels they have made camps. And now, Tenzing and Hillary both are at Camp 9. And you find the determination of Tenzing here. You know, whatsoever comes, I am going to be reaching on to the top. It is like a do or a die situation. Whatever happens, I am going to achieve or conquer the topmost point. Okay, so we set out early and all the way from Camp 9. So now they have moved on from Camp 9 and we alternated. So they have kept on changing. They keep on moving from one camp to the other. So this was their plan, that Tenzing is going to be the first person. He is going to take the lead, followed by him, Hillary. The man, he says, see, it is not easy to climb a mountain. It is a rough, rocky, slippery, okay? So, climbing is definitely a very difficult job. But the one who is climbing second, the task is even more difficult for him because he's like an anchor. He's the one who's going to fix on to the nails and tighten the rope. Okay, so everything is dependent on the second person who is following up and then even reverse down. He's going to cut the steps, break the way. So he's going to tighten and firm the rope which they are going to climb up. Now the author, or you would say Tenzing, is carrying along with him four flags. He has got Colonel Hunt. Now, Colonel is supposed to be the senior most military officer. So, all this entire expedition is being planned and arranged by the senior officer, right? So, the Colonel Hunt has given him three flags. That's of Britain, UN and Nepal. And he has instructed them, once you reach onto the top, you are supposed to place them or plant them onto the top. So the flag, you know, is a thing that should be taken utmost care of. So that's why he says these flags are in your care. So when you and Hillary reach the top, I am sure, put them onto the peak. I am sure that you and Hillary are going to do it. So he shows complete confidence. Colonel Hunt shows complete confidence in Tenzing and Hillary. Now, whatever one wants to do, one has to inform the senior most official. One cannot take a decision. So he tells him that he is also carrying along with him our Indian flag along with him. But he needs to take a permission. I had to ask Colonel Hunt's permission in his capacity as a leader of the expedition. So nothing can be hidden. Everything has to be brought on to the notice. It has to be informed to the senior most official, which he did. for which Colonel Hunt has appreciated him, or he said, "By all means, I am glad to know that you have brought an Indian flag." So yes, he being an Indian or Nepali Indian origin, definitely he had to have the Indian flag along with him. And he is a man who is going on to the top, so definitely our flag needs to be placed over there. Next, you can see how their journey is being described. See, they say that 1 hour has gone steady, it has moved very steadily, but then next it was very difficult. See, now they have moved south, then they are going westwards. There the journey has been little difficult because it had a steep line of rocks, so actually the speed gets reduced over there. And then it is once one is getting on to the top, the slow line, the snow covered incline, and the sloping was less, the snow was less over there, and the flattened summit almost together. So it's much easier on a flatter ground rather than the steep and the slopy areas. Then during the last 50 feet from the peak, Hillary and I were moving about 20 feet. There's not much of a distance between Hillary and Tenzing, just 20 feet apart, and they are both tied together, rope. It is just, if you happen to miss or lose it, lose the control of it, then you are slipping directly onto the ground. You might break your bones and you might not even get your bones. So you're falling from such a great height. So one has to be very careful. Most of the time the rope was loose. Okay, one has to tighten. The second person has to keep on tightening and fixing the rope, the nail and the rope properly. But when went over dangerous ground, we drew it taut. Taut meaning very tight. Now, this is where you can see the teamwork coming over. You know, if one would be selfish and not thinking about the other, then the journey upward would have been real dangerous. So, no selfish or jealous feelings across here. Now, this rope was a symbol. It tied us together. You know, there is no other way. There is no one to rescue. One has to be very alert, cautious, and keep on tightly to the rope. Okay, so we have to move as a team. You're not saying that let me go wherever you cannot be just self-centered and think about oneself. You have to think about your partner. He's also coming along with you. Only if two of them cooperate, they will be able to reach on to the top. So they were to be as a team. They were sent on a mission as a team. They had to reach on to the top as a team. Okay, so now he himself says, many a times he's been questioned, who's going to be the first? Okay, who was the first? So he says this thought never bothered him. Who's going to be first? If he's first, me first, that is Hillary or Tenzing, either one of us, it does not matter. But what matters is climbing and reaching onto the top, because you are all very much tensed in such a situation. Any other disturbing thought can just lose your control and you'll just fall down. So you have to be very cautious and alert while you're climbing. So all other thoughts are to be kept aside, you know, no other worries. Just like, for example, you are driving. If you keep on thinking some or the other thing, then you might go end up in an accident. That's why they say that don't attend to phone calls, be quite alert. So same is the case here. So he says it does not matter whether I reach or Hillary reaches the top. We had to, and you just cannot leave the other one behind and go on to the top and declare proudly to the world that I have won. No. So he says there was not much difference. Why? It says just 20 feet difference doesn't make a much of distance. It was not a much of a distance. So 1,000 feet height hai, somebody is falling from behind down, could एक्चुअली मेक आउट देन से दैट 1000 feet का डिफरेंस है. हाँ, हिलरी रीच फर्स्ट और टेंजिंग रीच फर्स्ट. सो देर वॉज हार्डली 20 feet अपार्ट डिस्टेंस. दैट डिड नॉट मैटर, राइट? सो वी कैन सी द स्पिरिट ऑफ बोथ द टीम मेम्बर्स हियर. ऑलराइट, वी शैल स्टॉप दिस वीडियो लेक्चर हियर एंड कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट. ओके, सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड अंटिल हियर. थैंक यू.